Welcome back to Farming Simulator 17, Goldcrest Valley. Your host with the most, I think, Mr. Blue here. How y'all doing, folks? My peoples? I'm doing just fine. Well, before I even start on the farming part, I'm gonna remember that saying I was saying. Head on down to Julia Bacher. Well, it's not really a Julia Bacher. I don't know where I got that from. It's Dumas Rucker. Dumas Walker. I'm sorry, Dumas Walker. Head on down to Dumas Walker is where I got it from. I guess I just inserted Julia Bacher somehow or another. Like I said, I didn't really know how or what, what I was saying, but I'm looking for my roller, folks. Oh, I hate not being able to find my stuff. But anyway, a friend of mine has found that. So I'm fixing to leave a thing right here. Well, hang on a sec. Let me get off this. I gotta find this roller real quick. And then I'll insert the link, or not the link, but a picture of the song. But of course, I can't play the song on here because of copyright issues, but I will leave the link. There's my roller. I don't see it nowhere. Oh, man, it's at the farm shop. Okay, that'll work. I drove all the way down here for nothing. Alright, I gotta go to field 18, I believe, yeah, 18. Pick up the, stump grinder. Then go to the farm shop, pick up the roller. Then we're gonna head up to the pig area. But folks, right here, alright, y'all see that link? I hope you did. I inserted it. But that's going to be the pic of Elsie. She found it for me. The song and everything. And also, I will leave a link. I'll try to insert it on the picture. But if not, I'll leave a link down in the description. It'll be the first link, if I don't forget, of the song. But let's all head down to Dennis Rucker. Dennis Walker. I'm still trying to add words to the song. But my peoples, we have a lot to do today, so we're going to try to get started. First off, I was trying to pick this thing up here. Our harvest is ready. Oh, come on. I had it, All right. But as you know, in the last episode, I had a terrible mishap with the wool. I got a little bit of it cleaned up. But not a lot. I took what I had on the trailer to the wool place and got a little bit of money. And well, I figured since I got the money, I might as well buy some. And I was just playing around off screen instead of actually getting the wool up. I went ahead and bought something for y'all. Raise that back up. But before you see it, I gotta go up here and get the packing roller from the shop, and then we'll go to pigs. And you'll be able to see it then. But folks, as you know, I have already cut these three fields of what I thought was corn, but come realize it was sunflowers. So I actually moved the combines over to corn, and they're cutting corn as we speak. And I had a 13 there. There's that roller. So I'm kind of hyped up because she found that for me. I didn't listen to it on the way home. Let the kids at school, and she texted me while I was at school and played it up there, and I'm like, oh, she found it. She found it. So thanks, Elsie, for finding it. I'm glad you found it. Now it's kind of like, it's still stuck in my head, a Julia Bakker, but now I know it's Dumas Rucker. Head on down to Dumas Rucker. I mean, Walker. Jesus. I'll get it out of my head pretty soon, folks, I swear. Alright, there's the combines. Look like they're both full. Uh-oh. Reason why I'm bringing this tractor up here is we got some stumps we got to cut. Some compacting at the pigs we got to do. And yes, folks, we have a great demand on wood chips. What am I going to do? So much stuff to do. Alright, what I want to do is get rid of this plow marks. But don't worry, what I compact will not be no grass grown, so that's a good thing. Well, folks, instead of doing all this right now, I'm going to do a little bit, but mostly we got to go get some corn, feed the pigs corn, and all that good stuff. Yep. So, yeah, I'm just going to show y'all. This is a shed I was talking about. It's actually a big barn instead of a shed. But we'll get in here too. Well, might be better to get out and do it. Over in here, I was thinking about putting like maybe some potatoes, beans, wheat, corn. So all our crops on this side, loosely. And on this side, we'll park our equipment. And whatever in the middle, you know. I don't think it's going to be big enough to do all that, so. Yeah. I don't want to go too far out because I just want to stop at the edge. But, folks, we're going to have a good time doing this. We're going to have a blessed day doing it. And hopefully everything goes well, so. I'll leave that there. I'm going to drop this here. And we're going to go get some trailers, offload the corn. I kind of wish these here was empty. I'm going to have to leave. Just have to take these two for right now. I should have put potatoes in this, and but I thought it was going to be more than that, and it didn't work out that way. So, yeah. Let's see. I think they're over this way, so let's go right through here. Yeah, they're over this way. Whoa. Easy does it, Mr. Blue. Let's see, y'all seeing this, it's probably the weekend, and I'm probably out of town as we speak, because I'm recording this on Friday, and so this evening, I'm probably going to be out of town, so that's why I'm trying to hurry up and get this recorded. Well, not hurry up, you know, it's going to take an hour regardless, but I do have to get it edited and uploaded before the kids get out of school. So currently it is 8:23 in the morning, so I should have plenty of time. Well, it roughly takes an hour and 10 minutes to record, because, you know, a lot of times I go over, and we all know this. And then, and it takes about an hour and 30 minutes, depending on how much editing I got to do. And I know one thing, I got to get my Bluetooth. I got a Bluetooth computer, and Look at me driving all out through this corn. Shame on me. I know, peoples. My peoples is not realistic. But neither are the AI. Oh my god, I keep forgetting about that feel. I gotta do that feel too, so. Hopefully, that feel over there. Hopefully, it won't disappear before the hour's up. No, save it and do it later when I get back. Because this should be Saturday when y'all are watching this. Saturday at 2 o'clock, hopefully. Nothing goes wrong. But, yeah. I get edited end screens and cards and all that put on there. And, cards. Where are cards, Mr. Blue? Cards is at the hour mark. It's three, well, minute mark, I should say. Minute mark. 3 minutes and 36 or 40, I think it's 3:46 is the time. It'll have on there, are you full? Yeah, we're 100% full lately. It will have on there, support Mr. Blue, or support Tommy Miller, actually. You click on that link and you can donate me some money. So, yeah, I'm still asking one of my friends out there to donate me $1 so I make sure that the site's working. So, yeah, ain't nobody done it yet. But when you do it, folks, make sure now that you comment me that you've done it. So that way I will know. It should fill the little piggies up. Oh my god, it hold the whole trailer. Alright, now that's what I call some hungry pigs. I like hungry hippos. Let's check here for a minute and see where they are actually at. Oh my god, folks. We might well just use the big boy. We'll just unload in the big grain cart and then, because our cows, we're going to leave them alone for a little bit. And our sheeps, they're doing pretty good. But we got 518 pigs? Oh my god, I need to get busy selling some of them. I'll tell you what, we don't have time to transport them. So I'm going to... It's really not going to hurt us. It is, but I ain't. Because, you know, it's going to be a fee. See down there, we're selling 38,400, but it's going to be a fee of 6,400. But this is a kind of desperate times. So, yeah, we're going to just take a loss this time around and sell down to about 300. So this is really where the money comes in, folks. You let them build up to that much. Yeah, my fingers are getting tired. Oh my goodness. Okay, we're down to 300. 218,000. We're losing 43,600. But folks, 218,000? Yes. We now have $260,000. Alright, I'm going to leave those trailers. Oh. We're going to leave those trailers there. Now, don't take in mind now, we still got wool to sell also. Why ain't you hooking up? There we go. Now, there's one tree that was in the way right here. And you see the stump right there. Other than that, everything looks good. You know, the concrete come down all the way, so I'm really impressed. All right, good. Since we got a, we have a, Oh, Wool's up too. We have the man at the sawmill for wood chips right now. And I wish we had some stacked up. I don't. So, having that in consideration, we need these trees gone. So, this is going to be kind of a... crap. Let's take care of the combines first. We gotta keep the corn going. All this corn goes directly to the pigs. Then we'll probably dump it inside that building, whatever's left. And then we're gonna turn right around and plant more next time. Alright, while he's doing that, I'm probably gonna use the map a lot to teleport between vehicles. Let's kind of speed things up. We need wood chips for the demand. That's more money coming in. Probably just another load at least. You know, as might well get them gone. Oh, we got the demand. God, would be off. I'm always off. That's what she said. Oh, Mr. Blue. You need to stop that. I know, I can't help it. But folks, I know y'all are curious why I'm going out of town. I know several of y'all are curious, but it's just going to have to wait till I get back. And you may or may not see. I don't know if I want to actually say it right now, because don't mean to be rude, but really it's not y'all's business. But Mr. Blue likes to share all his happiness with y'all, so yeah. Oh, don't do this. There we go. There we go. Get some of these. Ah! That want to go in the machine. I was trying to throw the log. There we go. I'm gonna have to. Now where's our combine? Way down there. But furthermore, it's going to be me going and taking some pictures and stuff. But a few other things are going to happen too. So yeah, let's just say I'm going to see an old friend. Leave it at that, okay? Alright. I'm going to lay out the beach, folks. I wish I could go to the beach. Mr. Boo, a.k.a. Tommy Miller, would like to go to, is that New Orleans? Somewhere down there. Actually, Cancun. Now, is it Cancun, Mexico, or... it's Cancun, somewhere down there. Mardi Gras, places like that. Never been. Didn't really want to go. It's just here lately, I'd like to see some new places and take pictures and stuff. Although I might not be able to take pictures down there, and what I heard, you know what I mean? Uh-huh. Ah, 25,000 even. I can hold a whole lot more, so I'm just gonna, yeah. Alright, we're back here. I'll get a couple of these tall ones away, and maybe some of these across the top here. So, we can do some mowing and stuff around this area. other than that, I don't have no news except Relay of Life is coming up. I don't know if I can be able to go to that or not, because I hate making plans, because if I make plans, they'll never come through for some reason. So, you make plans to go out of town on Mr. Blue? Well, it's not really a plan. I'm just going. I'm just going to see what's going to happen and leave it at that. Ain't no time's been set. I'm just told my friend I'll be that way sometime this weekend and left it at that. So. Whoa! Oh my god. What did Mr. Blue do? I can't jump out of this, because if I do, I'll drop the log. But we're going to see if we can turn this thing back over the other way. Alright, there we go. Don't know what happened. I think I got excited talking about this weekend and hit the wrong button there. But anyway, yeah, that's enough talk about this weekend. That's the farm talk now. Yeah, before y'all ask me some other questions that I don't want to answer. One of y'all probably going to ask, is this friend boy or girl? That I will never tell till I get back. Alright, get this big one, we'll be done good. Alright. Bam! Right on top of the shed. My brand new shed. Put a hole in it before we even use it. Yeah, that's what happened when I go, I hit the wrong button. Okay. That's probably gonna hang on the side. Nope. I'm pretty good right there. Good. But yeah, Relay for Life is coming up. I'll probably get with my source and see if I can go down there and videotape it. I don't know if it's something y'all may like or not, but hey, it's something coming up. I think it's in May. I'm not for sure. I have to look at the email again. And also, folks, if you want to email me, it is down below, I believe. If not, I'll seem to put it in there. Let's get this one right here. He seems lonely by himself. But it's all lowercase. LUXORAONE at gmail.com. If you want me to come out recording the thing for y'all, I'll be glad to do it. Just for taking mine now, I am not a professional. There's still things I fight every time I record, like batteries going dead and stuff like that. But I can record some stuff. Take some pictures or something if you want me to. Just email me and we'll set up a price or something, okay? I'm not starting a photo studio or nothing like that, but I do want to open myself up to more social gatherings and stuff. So yeah, I think this booger done got in there big time. And the chainsaw won't fix. Things loud, folks. But yeah, I like to get out and do more. And like, you got some things you want me to take pictures of or something? Oh no, not all y'all. I'd be more than glad to take pictures of them, but small things I may do for free or for the price of the CD or ink or whatever, you know, it'll be small fees for that. Mainly what I'm getting at. But if it's bigger projects, we might be talking about, you know, a little bit more of a pricing area there. But anyway, I'm not here to advertise because I really don't have nothing to advertise. Also, I had one of my buddies to Xbox me yesterday saying that might be one reason why I'm lagging a lot is because all the tree stumps and grass is laying around. So I'm like, yeah, I forgot about that. I got all the grass over laying around. And I've been noticing some quite a bit expense over where I was mowing the grass and I go across some of the old grass and it like pops up this big old hill grass. I mean, it's almost big enough to load the loader wagon. See, our truck looked like it might be full. And it is. Let's see here. Make sure I go the right way. I need to turn completely around. Don't knock over the wood chipper. Think about cutting those two trees there, folks. And then we got one. We got all these right here I want to cut that's on this green slab. And one right up there. But mostly before I leave, I want to cut a road right up through there. It's that green grass spot, right straight up through there. But I ain't talking about this episode, though. No. I wouldn't dare do y'all that way. I'm just saying before I leave that area with the scorpion, I would like to take some of those trees down. But if I get everything squared away, I think about trying to just get anybody come in and help me log, do some logging. That way I'll make some extra money and stuff. And what am I doing? There's a fence there. I can't go, Mr. Blue.
Sorry.
I was trying to get on the railroad track, take the shortcut here. You know Mr. Blue don't go by where it's supposed to be. What are y'all thinking? What was I thinking? And this conveyor belt here needs to go down to the cows. Because I have a little project down there we're going to do with all the hay that's fixing to come off that field. But yeah. I'll get the money roll in, folks. While that's there. Yes, folks, I still have this problem right here to go through. I've been trying to able to stack these up. But it's just like, you know, I went through all that hard work. And it's just like, I don't know. It's just not the same. It's like I don't want to pick them up. It's like, how dare y'all turn this trailer a little bit because the tree's in the way. I can't really get them on there straight with this thing, so thought about just kind of stacking them like that and then going around. So, anyway, we need to show y'all what's going on over here, but we need to get our combines rolling and stuff like that. All that is hay now. I went across the whole thing. I need to feed our sheep. Our sheep are getting low. So I figure I'd go ahead and gather it up a load real quick. with what I'm doing. You see why I went way over here? Because, you know, the other day when I was doing the mowing, I ran across some big old pylons. You know, it wasn't big when I ran across them, but after I went across them with the mower, it's like, oh my God, it's like, poof. So, yeah, I took the windrower over here, and you can see a little bit right there, right in the middle of that grass. I missed that spot. I don't know how I got way up there. I guess the mower, when it was hired worker. But, yeah, all this here is probably what's causing the trailer and stuff to flip out and all the lag issues. I don't know why it would be causing it way across, but, yeah. I had it all up around that. You couldn't see it, but when the windrower went across it, it actually rolled it up. So, really don't know what's going on in that area, but, yeah. I was kind of getting this up and around so we can roll. See, like, places like this right here, I done windrowed and I left it there. That's why it's so thick. And you can see them, see it's double wide there, but it's thicker. Yeah, but this is what I got to do. I'll do all this off screen probably Monday or something when I come back. It's taking a little bit long. What I was going to do is take this loader wagon up there and feed the sheep real fast, but. Go over this and it's a little bit bigger. All of that definitely feels a little bit faster. Now I'm going to switch over to the combines real quick. Yep, that's what I thought. This is probably going to be for Saturday. The next episode of Goldcrest will probably be Monday or Tuesday, even at 2 o'clock. This is a simple fact that I have so much to do on this map. Yeah, I don't want to bore y'all picking up all that wool. And then the tree cutting. And that one field over here. I'd like to get it before the farmer decides to cut it himself, so yeah. I think it's gonna almost fill me up. That is gonna fill me up where it looks. No, not quite. I can empty some out of it. Oh wow. The Challenger's bogging now. We're gonna take this up to the pigs and dump it and come right back, so they can probably pretty much hold all of it the way they are. Which of course I haven't checked it since we sold some of them. But I don't wanna touch that money. I want to pretty much save it. I wish we could put it back, but because the planter's going to take out of it and stuff like that. Wow. Okay, so we don't have to worry about the pigs on that except corn. So, alright. Yeah, I like to get everything back up to where all of them's full. That way I can fast forward time again. especially before I get planting again. So that's probably why the next episode might be a couple days from now. I know, y'all love it so much, but I'm afraid some of y'all I'm going to bore, and I don't want to bore y'all on any of my games, so that's, which I'm probably doing that anyway, just running my mouth. Oh, please don't hit. Ooh, that was lucky. But yeah, I say 1, 2, 3 more trees right there. And then these right over in here. Dang, worker. You can't pick that corn up because all that on barley there. That's what's wrong with you. Oh, you're going all crazy anyway. There you go, folks. You don't have to do nothing to drive the pipe over it. We'll go ahead and stop this worker. Leave him right here. Let me get the terror handler and pick up that barley there. Canola. I think it's canola. Oh my god, how much is these pigs going to hold? Well, that's good. They'll be full. How much more corn do we have, though? I think I only planted these 2 fields. Yeah, because that down there on 28 is wheat and barley for the straw. It's only 2 fields I bought for corn. Let's see here. Let's go take corn away. Alright, so send fires away. Ain't neither one of them. Wheat. Alright, 5 and 8 is wheat. Dang. Okay. Wow, folks. They took every single bit of that corn. How much more do they need? They still need a little bit. Wow. Alright, well. We'll just keep putting corn in this until we get all that taken care of, and we will probably start the other harvests when we come, or when I come back from this weekend. So yeah, see, he's already stopped over there, and he is. Hold up, mister. I don't want you doing nothing stupid like that. I'll carry you all the way to the road. Because that could have been Boo driving that, or Boo driving this. Which one was Boo on? Ah, Boo's on this one. Yep, Boo's on this one. Okay. What did I get up for? And just do this. And we need to come down here and get these trees right here out of the way too. Very badly. I think field 5 is going to be the last field I buy. Simple fact, because of the price it gives me for harvesting and stuff. I don't plant it, I don't plow it, but I do spray, fertilize, and thrash. So, yeah. Speaking of, folks, I know what we can do with this money. We can buy us another field. Let's see, we got all the fields except for field 31. She hasn't put nothing on field 31 yet. She wanted me to actually do a mission. So it's 460. We have that, folks. We have that right now. But, yeah. Now start both combines. Yeah, they're going. Okay. I like this. More money built up so we don't have to take from the bank. We probably got that much and wool laying around that I need to be getting up. So, would it hurt y'all's feelings if we spend some time on the wool? Now, let's try to get up some of it. Let me finish filling this up. Tell you what, we got about 20 minutes left on the game. I'm on a stop right here and finish filling this wagon up. I'll meet you back over at the Sheets Pilots, okay? I'll be right back. Alright, I am back here at the Sheets, as y'all can tell. I am going to unload this into the sheeps first. It wouldn't make no sense putting the thing. Let's see here. Go over to. Yes, they are filling up quite fast. Good. Perfect timing for the little thing. And this is scary, folks. That's way too close, but I like where I got it now. You don't have to go very far. Alrighty, so that is full. That's great. Anyway, I'm going to leave it right here. Because we're going to go on over here. Because we already got one pallet and a half accumulated. So, I'm going to have to hurry and get these up off the ground, folks, so... Which I don't know which one would be best, this grabber. Well, the other grabber wouldn't work, so. Oh, that would happen. That would happen. So, oh, right in my face. A lot of these are laying. I need the forks. But, I don't know. I'm actually thinking about getting out of the wool business. Because the way the pallet fork's been doing, I do have one more way of doing it. I'll probably do it before I do get out of business. Really, not very much holding that. Ah, ain't nothing holding it now. Oh, man. Anyway, these are going. Try it this way. I wanted to go to get the bale spike forks or a bale spike and try it. Okay, well, that's one way. The way these are laying, let me go get the bale spike. Because that probably worked a little bit better. Hopefully. It's just a ruckus, folks. It's a ruckus, I tell you. It's a conspiracy against Mr. Blue. I had all them stacked up so neatly. It was unreal. See, one, the bale spike is smaller. And it's probably easier to stab than the pallet fork is. But yeah. So I'm gonna make whoa. Little speed demon. I'll push all these down just a little. So I have room to load. I'll at least try to get some on the trailer and go sell. We have one. What are you doing, Mr. Blue? I'm trying to scoot this one down. Well, okay, see, it don't want to cooperate right on this trailer. Now there is a I think another flatbed. Crap, trying to get it to go up against the rail there. Yeah, like that right there. If I'm not mistaken, I think there is a flatbed trailer, but I don't know if it's got the fasteners on it. Now, if it's got the belt tensioners on it, the fasteners, whatever you want to call them, it'd be nice. Because it might be this trailer. I had this trailer for a long time, so. It could be one of the problems. I'm not for sure. But then again, it could be the belt tensioners that's causing the problems. So, yeah. But yeah, having to turn all these up and over is probably going to be painful. Which ain't no thinking about it. I know it's going to be painful. You have to get your forks lined up like ever so neatly. Oh, thank you. And having to zoom in to see is like really off, totally unfair. Let's go for another one, shall we? I can't remember how many I done sold, but I can give you that there was 34 on the trailer. So, yeah. Yeah, so far so good. But I think I want to buy field, is it 31? Miss Mary's field down there by the cows. Animal place you can buy the cows and stuff around. I think we're going to buy that field next. It's 470,000. Yes, I know I can save up my money and get that other one. We can catch a demand on the soybeans. I know we could get it, but that's probably neither there or here, so. Alrighty. I wish it was that easy. Maybe that's what I'm doing wrong. I need to quit loading double pallets when I do it over at the sheep's place. I'm going to load this one up, and then we're going to check on the combines. I know they should be full by now. Come on. Dab it. Dab it good. Yes. This is what kills me. I wish it was a camera view out on the fork, sir. That would be a little bit better about seeing, because, you know, if you get up close, you have to zoom out, and then you can't really see. So, darn if you do, and darn if you don't. Alright, we're going to see about maybe one or two more, and then we're probably going to go sell. Alright. Facebook. Perfect. All right, since we got that in there, let's go check on the combines. Oop, went too far. And they look like they're all jumped up here together. Oop. Ah. This is us speaking. Jason and Boo talking again. Am I going to have to replace y'all too? You are full, so let him go. Alright, folks, the way this looks is going to conclude the corn harvest. What, really? Oh my goodness. We're gonna dump a little team of the grain auger wagon. While those two are unloading, it's gonna stomp. Alright. Get two stomps. My lovely lady stomps. Alright, that's not. It must. Oh! So say they didn't like me saying that. All right. Oop, wrong way. All righty. I'll just go ahead and use both. I might get this note here that'd be done so I can just swap back and, instead of waiting. Oh, wrong way. Alright, 127 liters of corn. And folks, that concludes the corn harvest. Now we're going to have to take these headers off and put our other headers on. I'm on. Oh, I'm on the wrong one. Alright, I ain't gonna bother washing the corn headers. I wouldn't use that much. We'll wait until they get funky, funky, funky. Oh, yeah. Yep, wrong one. I gotta carry this to the shop. See, this is what kills the time on a video is pretty much is driving from here to there. Folks, I gotta say, that is my first Coke. It's a McDonald's large Coke. That is my first one for today. When we went to McDonald's, I ordered a large water. Well, what it was, my daughter actually wanted a Coke of her own this morning. Which, I usually give them, that's about the only Coke they actually get during the day. Besides what they drank at school or whatever. Why are you not hooking up? And, so, my son always gets a Coke. And I usually get one, and my mom gets her senior coffees. So it would have been three large Cokes. Well, I ended up getting that large water with the three large Cokes. So, having all that said, I drank a water this morning instead of a Coke, and when I take my medicine early in the morning, I always drink that bottle of water. There for a while, I didn't used to do that, so it used to be Coke, Coke, Coke. So now I have actually cut down, and my next Coke will probably be at supper. And I'm going to try to just have one. So if I do that, it'll be two Cokes today that I drank. So yes, I am trying to cut them out, folks. I am trying. It's hard. It's hard because that drink right there was just like, oh my God, it's so good. It's like a kid being in a candy store, a rich person being in a bank vault. But yeah, y'all get the impression. Yeah, y'all know how it is when you love something so much, but yet it's bad for you. I have been having some sugar spikes, but folks, it's not around my sodas. I know y'all don't believe me, but like right now my sugar's like 180, and I just drank a Coke. I can check it here in about 15 minutes, again in an hour, and again in 2 hours, my sugar will stay average around the same. But it'll be like, I guess it's the food I eat or something. I know if you eat potatoes, you don't get that sugar instantly. You get that sugar in about 4 or 5 hours later. Or at least that's what I've always been told. And it seems about right. You eat mashed potatoes or baked potatoes and stuff, you don't get that sugar rush right away. You get it later on. Alright, folks, I'm probably going to just park these guys right here. Our next harvest, all the Adler fields, 12, 14, 15, 16, 19, 13, and 9, has been harvested. So I'm thinking about starting over at 11, doing 11, 18, 22, 23, and 24, and 26. And then we're going to go around to 20. And then go down 30, 29, 20, 25, stuff like that. I wish 31 was barley. Yeah, it's barley, but she done harvested. Or actually, I did. 460, folks. And we got 260. We got two in the bank. You know, I'm thinking about going ahead and buying it. What do y'all think? But let's get some more of these wool pallets on the trailer. Since this is the last episode, I might go a little bit longer than an hour. Yeah. And yes, folks, I am going to double stack. We got to. We're going to try to get as many on here as possible in the next few minutes. I think I better go right there. Alright, I want to put a couple more on this side. Because I hate to, I know, oh good God, we got a lot on that side. Oh, what was I thinking? What was I thinking? Triple stacking. Oh, man. Guess what? It's hard for me to see. I don't know about y'all, but... Oh, thank you. There I go. It just don't want to let go once it attaches. Why me? Dear farming god, the old great one of farming simulator, why me? Cause you done got too many episodes, oh mighty blue. You have too many episodes, it's time for you to move on. Never, great one, never. I'm going to keep making them for my YouTubers. My YouTube and Facebook friends must see more videos. Oh, folks, y'all think that's crazy. Y'all are see the, I'm going to have to insert it on one of these videos. I have a small video clip of me disguised in camo. If you got Facebook, y'all seen them on there. They're the face shields or face mask deals. That's like $5 for $15, or you know, they got skulls, camouflage, black clown faces, all them on these masks. Well, I actually bought some, and I made a video clip playing around on it, saying that I want subscribers. Subscribe to my channel now, or I will kill you or something like that. And I think it's pretty cute. Y'all might not, but oh crap. Let me squeeze around over here. I hope there ain't no other pallets anywhere else. Dang, all these gonna be the wrong way. Let's see if I can screw them. Might be able to get that. Well, I guess that's one way. How did I know that's gonna happen right here? See, it don't want to let go when you touch the bottom of it. It don't want to let go at all. Okay. Try to put it right here. And then we'll fasten that down. Alright, I'm going to fasten that down. Where are you? Okay, right there. There. And then try to add a couple on this side. Most likely I'm going to have to come back and get some more, because maybe I just need to start picking them up like that. I'm going to add this into the top one here. This goes, well, I guess it was tied down, wasn't it? Alright, folks, I think I'm going to go ahead and haul this off. The price is still up pretty good, I think. I don't know. I need one or two. Let's look at the price real quick. Well, the price is still going up, so in that case, let's just see how many more of these we can actually stick from the bottom and just try to lay up there. Well, okay. No! Well, look at there. It got the right way up. Scoot these away from these trees, I'll be alright. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. I did it. I thought I saw a pretty cat. You did see a pretty cat. I do. That's what I see. George. Don't call me George. My name's Bill. Oh, hey, Bill. How you doing? No, folks, I'm not going crazy. I'm just bored. You ever get bored and you just go bonkers? I'm thinking about this weekend. I'm nervous and everything, and don't know what for, you know. When you ain't seen somebody in a long time, I guess you get that way. Alright. We need to turn some of these over. I guess we did like that. And I even grabbed one. Ah! Well, no, no, no. Not like that, Mr. Brewery. I don't want to mess up the good stack. Well, trying to get it right there. Yes. What? Okay. Oh, that ain't good. That ain't good. Folks, I'm sorry. Well, that's good. Sorry this is taking up most of the video, but this is part of it now. And maybe y'all get to see some crazy things here in a second. See, it don't want to let go. But it's good this time, I think. Because I am going to try to place this one right here. Uh-huh. Oh, that's perfect. That is perfect. I'm going to get some of these out here. Man, get to them and stuff better. Come on. I need you to turn, mister. Or miss, whatever you are. Yeah, that's perfect. Thank you. Somebody said here a while back, I make this look so easy. I wish I was making it look that way now. Was that? Oh, I thought that was another wool pallet over there. I'm like, no! But, folks, y'all seen how high I had it. And like I said, I like two pallets from having 36 pallets on here. I'm glad I went and sold a few of those others. Because I probably never would have get it stacked back that neat. I need that in there to turn. No. Oh, it's going to fall off. Oh, it's going to fall off. I just know it's going to fall off before I go for it. Oh, slow down, boo. Slow down. We're going to extend my arm out and reach to put it back on. Gently. See, you can't get no good camera views. All right, I think it's going to be pretty good. Can't really get no good grab either. Alright, folks, I think I was only had like 20 minutes, but we're like 8 minutes past the hour, so I'm going to go a little bit more. I just want to get all these on there and sell them so y'all can see. Come on. There we go. Oh, here we go again. Y'all see it. See it? This is what I'm talking about. It will not let go of the pallet. when it's doing that. So, what did a person do? It's like it does it when it gets around the trailer. That's how the trailer did. Right there. That is exactly how the trailer did. Come back here. Before I run over you with the train. Alright, you stay right there so I can get hooked up to you. Okay, I think it's over with now. I don't know what makes it do that. I really don't, folks. Could it be all the grass that's up there? I need my forks back now. Oh. Well, I didn't want to do that. Send this thing back in, so. Ah, quit that. I gotta get another controller, too, folks. Not for this, and this one does pretty good, but I just got thinking. For the PC, my right button, LB button, or LB button is, no, my right B button is sticking. I'll get it out here in a minute. Alright. Folks, I'm getting low on time, so we're going to go ahead and... Let me see here. Let me zoom in. See, unfasten belts and refasten belts. So they're all are tied down now. And we're going to go and take and sell this. And we got what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pallets left. I'll just add them to the ones that's over here by the sheeps when we go sell them. We'll get them in the next episode of this, and they'll give us another. Whoa, is that one out in the field? That looked like a pallet out in the field. Wow. But, I need, 2 more videos to record today. Because this would be Saturday at 2, so I need to get Sundays at 11 and Sunday at 2 videos done, which those won't take long. I don't know if I do Sanofka or Giants Island. Probably need to do American Farm. I don't know about that map, folks. I can't seem to... We probably can still play it, but as far as... Oh, I'll pull in here this time because I got the trailer home last time back here. Get these off the front. But the last time I played American Farm, I tried to do a mission and I never could get it done with the mission. So I'm actually thinking they do not have the times correct on the missions, not giving us enough time. Because I even done the cheat on one of the times. And it's like still 3 rounds from being to the end, so that's not right. So, are we selling? Well, yeah, our money's going up. Look at that, folks, almost 300,000. 300,000 right there. And we still got a lot of wool to go. Well, while that's selling, I want to bebop around. I think I got this guy empty. Try to get this going. See if we can look. Yeah, that trailer was empty, so. All we gotta do is a clean up here. And I believe there's a few more dollars coming in. I need to hop out of this. Hop into this one. And I need to shorten. Come on. About right there. So your money is still coming in, so it's still selling the wool. And that's good. Oh, our money stopped. 89,384 in wool sold. Wow, folks, that's a lot. And we still got 3 pallets to go. I mean 6 pallets. I was thinking about 3 across. It might be something new with this trailer, I don't know. It sure is laggy when we get around it. I wish that dumpster wasn't there. Alright, folks, I want to go into trailers. See, we only got those 2 trailers. I thought they said something about a flatbed being. Must be on my PC. Now, if I went ahead and grabbed those other 7 pallets, we probably would have been right at the money for that fuel. Wow, folks. Wow. Alright, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go ahead and get that fuel for y'all. That's probably a little bit too much. It only puts us like 60,000. So, I don't know why I jump out and go. Alright, she still ain't planted nothing on it. So, 460,728. Folks, we are buying it. It is ours now. Check this out. Now we can say we own pretty much from biogas plant down, even across. And I'm also thinking about buying field 8, probably on the episode when we get back, because all them there. Only thing about 1 and 6 that I hate is that it's right there at the top where it ain't nothing. You have to drive up a big hill. It's nothing but incline on both those roads going to 1 and 6 there. So whatever we put in 1 and 6 will probably be whatever's high at Wright's agribusiness, which is Soybeans the highest probably. We might plant wheat up there and direct sell it to Rye Agribusiness. Wheat or canola. Canola's pretty high up there. That and sunflowers. So we'll probably plant canola and sunflowers up in that area whenever we get to buying those fields. So, yeah. But, yeah, folks, we have a few more wool pallets to go, so we got to get all these turned over. So I guess we'll do all this next time. And I just want to say thank you for watching. And once again, Elsie, if you're watching this, thank you for finding that song for me. You know, like I said, I didn't know really what it was called, because I thought it was Head On Back to Julia Boggers, but it's Doris Walker. I knew I heard it. That is the song. But, you know, like I said, I was saying it wrong all these times in my head. I guess that's why nobody knew what I thought, because I was saying it wrong. Oh, don't turn back over. But, again, thank you, Elsie, and thank you, all my subscribers for subscribing. Folks, hit that like button. Share, subscribe. If you ain't done it already, turn on the post notifications. That way you'll get all the videos when I first post them. And, yeah, I guess that's gonna be it for this episode. I'm gonna finish turning these over and get them loaded while we are, or while I am waiting for them to render off the Elgato. So, folks, once again, thank you very, very, very much. You don't know how important it is to me. Up to 32 subscribers now. I'm getting a lot of likes and views off my videos. I went back to my first video I ever made, and I'm like, oh my God, I didn't know I had that many likes on this, and you know, I can't see that. I can see that my likes are up, but I really can't see on which video until I go all the way back and look, and I had no idea. I'm like, oh my God. So, yes, folks, thank you very, very much. All right. I guess I'm going to get off of here, and may y'all have a blessed day, a very happy day, as always. And you've been Farming Simulator 17, Goldcrest Valley, from Mr. Blue, your host, I think, for the most. You never know about me. But yes, folks, y'all have a blessed day, and I got to get off here, so later. Bye.